Last week, I made a video about document expired notification to be sent on emails to the users. And there was a comment in that video that I need to send to those people only for those people who had the documents already expired. So for that, we need to apply a small logic into that flow, which we are going to look in this video. Hi, I'm Mohammed Adnan, and welcome to my channel, Tech18. In this channel, we discuss a lot about the Power Automate, Power BI, Power Apps, Alteryx, SQL, Excel, YouTube, and much more. If you're visiting first time to my channel, or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. So now let's go into the Power BI Desktop. Again, as a practice, I'm going to create a new flow from here, Power BI Desktop. Clicking on this, it'll open up a visual here in Power BI Desktop, and before to that, I need to add an emails here and the expiry document. It has to be regular date, name and type. And then we need to set up a flow. Click on this and edit. It will open up the Power flow inside to Power BI Desktop itself. I'm going to create a new one. So clicking on new, and then from not from a template, it has to be an instant cloud flow. So when Power BI button is clicked, because this is going to be a button inside the Power BI, so it is mentioned as Power BI button clicked, and you add a new step. So it is basically a control thing I need to add now, and it has to be applied for each and every row of that particular table. And then I need to select this one, click on here, it will list out all the data available here. I'm going to select the Power BI expiry date, data name. So I need to click on Power BI data item. So each and every Power BI data item is going to apply the logic. I need to delete this one. Additionally, it has created. So now I'm going to add an action. So clicking on that, again, I'm going to add a control. Here, I'm going to use the control switch. What control is, I need to select a value, and here when selecting this one, it gives me list of options here. Here I need to select the expiry date, user ID, user name, Power BI data expiry date. So when clicking on this one, it comes up here, is this expiry date should be less than today's date, right? So for that, here in the choose value, you don't have today's date here. In the expression, you had to go UTC now. So UTC now is the current date and time. Select this one function and click OK. So it adds up here. So basically what we are saying, for each and every row in the data set, it has to check that the expiry date is less than to current date and time or not. If it is less than, then I want it to send an email. So clicking on this one and click on the email, you can send an email here stating to the user. So basically the user is, you have user email ID here, so you can use the user email. So Power BI data email, it's here, and the subject, you can also define that. So your document expired. Basically here you can define multiple options here. Hey, and then the user name, your particular document, we have that name as well, the type of the document, your document has expired on, and then we can also add the date time here, expiry date. Thanks and regards. Like 18, please renew as soon as possible. So these are things which we have done, and click on save. So the name, we can give it a name here, email expiry email with condition. Save a name and click on back and apply. You need to click on apply, not apply this flow to that particular button. and click on back to report. The formatting and everything which we had discussed earlier as well, so you can go and watch out that video. I'm just clicking on control click to run this one. It's triggering. Now it's triggered. So the flow is run success. Now let's have a look at my email. I got in two email. Hey Adnan, your passport has expired on this date. Please renew as soon as possible. Thanks and record take 18. And then hi Michael, your passport has expired on this date. Cool, right? So right now you got only two email, not the three like before. So this is how you can able to set up any small if conditions to filter the data when running the flow using the Power BI dataset. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed it, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you're not a member of our channel, just hit the join button to know in detail about it. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.